So here in this video, we will study about the bone grafting, the properties of the bone grafting, various types of the bone grafting. So the three properties, basic properties of the bone grafting, we have the osteogenesis, osteoconduction and the osteoinductive property. So starting with the osteogenic property. So as the name indicate, osteogenesis, so it helps in the genesis of the bone. It helps in the formation of bone. So it has the living stem cells, mesenchymal stem cells, precursor cells, that will differentiate into the osteoblast and form the bone. So this is the osteogenesis, which has the mesenchymal stem cells, which have the precursor cells. Second property is the osteoconductive. So as the name indicates, it helps in the conduction of the osteogenesis. So conduction means it's provided a bony scaffold is formed, a 3D scaffold is formed, which will help the in growth of capillaries, which will help the osteogenesis. So in osteoconduction, it will only provide a scaffold. It will provide a mechanical support and a scaffold in which the ingrowth of capillaries will occur and the bony growth will occur. Now third property is the osteoinductive. So as the name indicates, it helps in the induction of the osteogenesis. So various growth factors, various platelet drive growth factors, various other growth factors, various BMPs, insulin-like growth factors, they all comes in the osteoinductive property. So a bone graft can have all the three properties, two of them or even one property. So osteogenesis, it helps in the generation of the bone. Osteoconductive, it helps in the conduction. It forms a scaffold in which the osteogenesis will occur. While osteoinductive will help in the induction. It will help in the osteogenesis from the transforming from the stem cells to the osteoblast. Now coming upon to the various types. So we can have the autograft, allograft and the bone graft substitutes. So autograft, as the name indicates, it is taken from the body itself, patient body itself. So it can be either cancellous, cortical, corticocancellous or vascularized. So cancellous, we have the example of the Lycrest bone graft. Cortical, we have the fibula bone graft. Corticocancellous, again in Lycrus we can have a corticocancellous component, and in vascularized, so a part of the bone graft along with the associated artery spline, which will be anastomose over the donor, over the recipient site. So we have the various example for the vascularized bone graft. We have the fibula with the associated peroneal artery. We have the Lycrus bone graft with the associated artery. We have the distal and radius bone graft, which is used in the scaphoid fracture with the associated blood supply. So in autograft, we have the cancellous, cortical, corticocancellous and the vascularized type. Now what are the various merits and demerits of the autograft? So as it is taken from the patient body itself, so there is no immunogenic reaction to the autograft. But it may lead to the, it may cause the donor site infection, donor site all complication can also occur. So these donor site complications are removed in the allograft, which is taken from the cadaveric specimens. Now as they are taken from the cadavers, we have to get the immunized them firstly by the various procedures, various processing things. So we can either go for the fresh frozen, freeze dried and the demineralized bone matrix. So these are the various processing techniques. So the allografts, they are classified mostly on the basis of their processing techniques, the way they are processed. So they can be either fresh frozen, freeze dried or demineralized bone matrix. So among them, the important one is the demineralized bone matrix. So we will discuss about it in detail a bit. So demineralized bone matrix, it is prepared from the cadaveric human bone. As we have discussed, it is an allograft. So how we do it? So we go for the acid extraction of the bone. So we demineralize the bone. What remains is the collagen, non-collagen proteins and the bone growth factor, BMPs. So we have discussed BMP have the osteoinductive property. So this demineralized bone matrix has a osteoinductive property along with the other properties. So this was about the allograft. So allograft, what it has a benefit over the autograft is that the all the donor site complications are eliminated in the allograft part. But it has a disease transmission risk. It has a risk of the immune sensitization. Now, we have the third variety. We have the various bone graft substitutes, which are rarely used alone. They are always used along with the autograft and the or the allograft. So among the bone graft substitute, we have the calcium sulfate, calcium phosphate, and calcium hydroxyapatite. Now we will study about the various properties of these bone graft. Now, starting with the autograft. So in bone marrow, so we have discussed the properties, various osteogenesis, osteoconduction, induction, mechanical property, and the vascularity. So we will discuss it one by one. So bone marrow. Bone marrow will have the osteogenic and the osteoinduction property. There won't be any osteoconduction, mechanical property, or vascularity. In cancellous part, the osteogenesis and the osteoinduction part will be more. Mechanical part will be a bit on the lower side and no vascularity will be there. Cortical part, there will be a mechanical stability more along with the bit of osteogenesis and osteoconduction, but osteoinductive part is on the less side and vascularity is again not there. Now specifically vascularized bone graft, they have a osteogenesis property, osteoconduction property, they have a mechanical property, and there is a additional benefit of the vascularity. So vascularized bone graft, they will help the early incorporation because of the vascularity. They will be incorporated early as compared to the non-vascularized bone graft. Coming to the allograft. So in allograft, in the cancellous part, cancellous will have a osteoconduction property because it will serve as a scaffold. Because the osteogenic and the osteoinduction property will be removed because of the processing procedures. So it will only serve as a scaffold, providing the osteoconduction property. In cortical part, again, it will serve as a mechanical property because all these properties are eliminated because of the processing procedure. But in demineralized bone graft, as we have discussed, that there is a plenty of the bone mineralized protein. So there is a osteoinduction property, which is seen in the demineralized bone matrix. Along with a bit of osteoinduction property is also there. So allograft basically serve as a scaffold. It doesn't have any osteogenic or osteoinduction except in the demineralized bone matrix, which has a plenty of the BMPs so that osteoinduction is preserved. So this was about the various properties. Now an important component is the incorporation of the bone graft. So cancellous and the cortical part will be incorporated differently. So in cancellous part, we have the three phases. In phase 1, there is inflammation and the revascularization of the graft, which is followed by the osteoblastic laydown and associated osteoclastic resorption will occur. So this is known as creeping substitution, where a osteoblastic laydown and osteoclastic resorption is occurring side by side. And a bone will be laid down by the osteoblast. So there will be a creeping substitution, and finally a remodeling will be done to convert the woven bone into the lamellar bone. But in cortical part, there will be slower inflammation and the revascularization response. And first, there will be osteoclastic resorption in the first 3 to 6 months by the cutting cone mechanism. So cortical bone graft will be resolved first. So there will be a mechanical loss of the strength initially in the resorption phase. Only after the resorption phase is over, the appositional bone formation will occur. Appositional bone formation means that bone growth will occur from periosteum inwards. So resorption will continue and the bone formation will occur appositionally. Firstly, periosteum, the osteoblasts on the periosteal surface will form the bone, and appositional bone formation will be there, and there won't be any remodeling phase in the cortical part. So a creeping substitution phase occurs in the cancellous part, and a cutting cone mechanism occurs in the cortical part. So that was a brief overview of the bone grafting, the various types of the bone grafting, properties of the bone grafting, and the graft incorporation. Thank you.